And gaming, this is my series Gaming Career Skills. Today we're going to be talking about how to add your alerts on YouTube and Twitch, including your follow, most recent follower, subscriber, and your last donation. So let's get into the video. So you guys want to be able to have cool Twitch pop-ups or Twitch alerts just like this one Ninja has here for your Twitch account or your YouTube account, and it's a very simple process to get this going. There you see his tier for subscribing, for people signing up and subscribing to Ninja here. But you can get follow ones, etc. So that's really neat, cool feature to have to let your subscribers know, hey, thank you for your support. So you can see these are consistently popping up when people do subscribe to Ninja here. And I do the same thing for my streams on Twitch, Light Skin Gaming all the time. And I'm going to show you guys how to do that. So the first thing you're going to want to do is, if you're a streamer and you use OBS, I recommend you use OBS Streamlabs. It's just easier, simpler, and quicker. So I'll leave a link in the description box for OBS Streamlabs. It'll take you to a page that looks similar like this. Ninja uses this one, and all the other mega famous streamers use this software. So you're just going to simply download that. So once you've downloaded Streamlabs, it might take you to a page that looks like this. And up here you can see that it has the dashboard, cloud bot, app store, etc. We're gonna go to themes. So if you just got this, you're gonna go ahead and download a theme because you might be just beginning streaming. I recommend one of these themes by Nerd or Die. Honestly, any of the themes by Nerd or Die are really well put together and just thought out, nice transitions with them. So I highly recommend them. And all you'd have to do to go with this is 100% free. You just click install overlay. So you just click install overlay. If you want the animated version, you can buy it, but it costs money. But you just install this basic overlay. And then once you've done that, it will take you to an editor. And it will look not like this, but you'll have a whole bunch of different things. Like, for example, my Predator one. I have this one here for my Twitch. It's all a little messy, but you get the idea. And it comes with an alert box pre-installed. If you go into your sources here, alert box is already installed, and it looks like this. So voila, done, alert box. You uncheck the ones you don't want. So I stream on Twitch, so I don't want Super Chat, and I don't need my merch because I don't really have merch. And you can go ahead and look and click these. So I can click this. Okay, I know which ones I want. I have unchecked the ones I want over here. And then on the left-hand side, there's a little plus sign. So you can extend it out and you can look at it and you can change all the settings over here. So first you can change the title. So it's gonna say, Fortnitey boy donated $1. That's how that works there. And I can change the font of that to whatever I want. It's crazy amounts of fonts there. You can change the size, the weight of the font, the color, etc. Media, you can change the picture that comes up with it and the sound, and you can control how loud the sound is. Animation, how it comes in, how it goes out. Donor message, so if they want to send a message with their donation, how much is the minimum amount they have to donate to show that message, and have text to speech as well. You can have text to speech, which is kind of neat. And then alert settings is the minimum amount to trigger an alert, which is pretty cool. So if you're getting spammed with dollar donos, that's not going to override your stream. So that's pretty much all the settings you really need to know about, except for layout. I generally recommend the basic layout anyways, so the far left layout's usually nice. And you can go and customize each one of these for each type of alert. All right, there's also the FPS for it, recommended 30 frames per second. You don't need to eat up your computer's resources for that. All right, so that's how that's done. It's already really done for you. But say if you made your custom theme and you don't have an alert in there, all you have to do is click sources and click alert box and then add source. Add new source, because for me, but it's gonna say add new source, and you do the same process. It's the exact same process. All right, so that's how you do it. Again, I'll show you one more time. If you didn't get that, say if you had your own custom alert box or settings and you needed to add, you just click the add sources. I'll show you again. Sources, click the plus button. Widgets, alert box, add source, add new source, and go through the exact same process I just mentioned. All right. Now let's say if you don't want to use your alert box on OBS Streamlabs, maybe you want to use it on
OBS, the original, or Mixer, or something weird, Split, or whatever you guys use to broadcast. Well, what you guys can do actually is go to the dashboard of Streamlabs, and you can go ahead after that and go to Widgets. So Dashboard, then Widgets, and then you can click Alert Box. Once you've clicked Alert Box, you can do the exact same process. It just looks a little bit different. There's their Donations tab. You can select which ones you do and do not want. Right now, I have them all as I want. But for example, if I'm streaming on Twitch, I don't want Super Chats. And I don't have merch, so I don't want merch. So I'll uncheck those, and then I'll go to these tabs, and I'll customize them. The image, the sound, the volume, what it says, text-to-speech, all that down there. Very important stuff that you should check out. But let's just say you're done and you went through all the things you want to customize. All you have to do is click copy and then go into your streaming service, whatever you use to broadcast. For example, I'll use this again. And you're going to add a source as a browser source or a web source. And you can add it, name it, alert box. Copy and paste the URL that they give you into the URL section and click done. And voila, I have another alert box. So you can even test this alert box. So you can have two tabs up. So if I had my OBS here and I wanted to test it, you can click test. And if I go, it pops up over here. So that's how it's done, guys. I hope you learned something from this video. If you liked the video, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, thank you guys for watching.